The investigation into the cataclysmic event that radically changed planet Earth begins in the deep frozen land of Siberia. 50% bigger than the entire United States, this land is locked in ice for most of the year. Temperatures plummet to minus 90 degrees Fahrenheit and below. But in summer, the ice melts and reveals one of the largest and most mysterious geological formations on Earth, the Siberian Traps. Nearly 5% of Earth's land mass is covered by this ancient sea of rock. Deep canyons expose layers hundreds of feet thick. These giant stepped formations are called traps, from the Swedish word for stairs. They were discovered under unusual circumstances. Polish geologist Alexander Czekanowski was exiled to Siberia in 1863 for political crimes against Russia. While banished, he surveyed the landscape and stumbled upon this unique, unexplained expanse of layered rock. Today, the journey to fully understand how this strange stone formation was made begins in a swamp.
I'm not sitting in this swamp just for fun. This swamp's actually very characteristic of what Siberia was probably like before the Siberian Traps formed. This vegetation, this shallow, stagnant water, is very different to the environment we see in Siberia today.
The clue that enabled scientists to figure out that Siberia was once a swamp came from a particular kind of rock found beneath the traps. Coal. Trillions of tons of it.
This rock here is coal. It's very important in Siberia. It forms when plant matter, trees, and thick vegetation dies and falls into a swamp. And over millions of years of geological time, they're compressed into a hard rock substance like the one I'm holding in my hand today.
The age of the coal was determined by dating the plant fossils trapped inside the rock. The process revealed that the coal was formed more than 300 million years ago. It continued to collect and be compressed over the next 50 million years.
So the environment was very stable, swamps, thick vegetation. And then suddenly, 250 million years ago, it all stops and you have the Siberian Traps lying on top of the coal. So something very dramatic must have happened at that time. So we really need to study this phenomenon to investigate the geology and see what we can find out.
But investigating the geology of the Siberian Traps is no easy task because they're located in one of the most remote and least explored areas of the planet. It's an arduous journey for Howard and his team, a 1,000-mile trek through Siberia over land and water, camping out in mosquito-infested forests.
Taking us nearly 7 days to get to this remote corner of Siberia, but this afternoon we finally found the rocks that we were hoping to study.
These towering pinnacles of rock mark the edge of the Siberian Traps. Even from a distance, without leaving their boat, the geologists can identify this distinctive formation.
The rocks you can see behind me are all basalts forming wonderful towers. We've stopped and studied these in several locations, and what we've seen is only a tiny part of the basalt covers such a large part of Siberia.
This evidence unlocks the mystery of how the traps were made. Basalt is what geologists call igneous rock. That only comes from one source, a volcanic eruption. The Siberian Traps must once have been a vast, red-hot lava field.
I think the Siberian Traps would have been 1,000 times more intense than anything I've seen doing my own field work. And if I could go in a time machine and watch it all happen, it would be really just fantastic to see the scale of it, the length of the lava flows and the height of the fire fountains. It would have been really something to see.
There are several types of lava rock. This basaltic lava is a free-flowing liquid when it first erupts from the ground.
Just looking at how fluid this rock appears gives us some of the clues what it might have been like in Siberia if we could have gone there. There would have been really gooey, goopy, runny lava flowing across the land surface for 1,000 miles in all directions.
This semi-liquid lava gives these rocky plains their name, flood basalts. They still erupt today in Kilauea in Hawaii, currently the world's most active volcano. After 25 years of constant eruption, the basalt lava field has engulfed more than 4 square miles of Hawaii's Big Island. But the Siberian traps are bigger, 500,000 times bigger. Each distinct step is laid down by an individual lava flow. Layer pours out upon layer until the traps are more than a mile deep in black hardtop. Over an area nearly the size of the continental U.S.
So imagine the entire United States covered in a lumpy, uneven parking lot, like asphalt everywhere as far as the eye can see. And that is what the Siberian traps looked like when it first formed.
Geologists have discovered how the traps were made. The next step is calculating how long this vast Siberian super eruption lasted.
Fortunately, volcanic rocks contain little minerals that formed when the rock crystallized, when the rock cooled and solidified. And some of these minerals are radioactive and they decay over time. And so they're like little time clocks. They start when the rock cools, and then when we measure them, the clock stops and we know how much time has passed since that rock formed.
Dating the oldest lava here reveals that the Siberian traps first ripped the landscape apart 250 million years ago. And by also dating the youngest lava, scientists can figure out exactly how long the eruptions lasted. The results are surprising. They show that lava carried on pouring out and building up into ever deeper layers for an almost unimaginable 1 million years, forging the largest lava flow on land. The next step in the journey is to figure out why this vast eruption happened here in Siberia. Most volcanoes exist at plate boundaries, thin spots on Earth's crust where the floating plates that support the continents jostle together as they drift across the face of the Earth. Yet the Siberian traps are right in the heart of a huge continent. So experts have to come up with an explanation.
This is a mantle plume. It may not look like it, and you have to imagine that this is going on over about 1,500 miles rather than a bottle. But it's quite a good simulation of how mantle plumes work. They're heated from below. This candle is the Earth's core, supplying heat. And this is the bottom of the mantle, and the heat is heating up some of the mantle, and it rises up as these blobs up towards the Siberian traps, which are up at the top here.
Mantle plumes are one of geology's great mysteries. No one knows why they switch on or off, but their shape is a crucial clue as to why plume eruptions are so fierce and so massive.
That mushroom head, in reality, can be 1,500 miles across. And so the volcanic eruptions can cover huge areas, hundreds of thousands of square miles. And also the actual head is a very short-lived phenomenon. That probably erupts in hundreds of thousands of years, at most a million years.